Hey guys, welcome to Grad Coach TV. My name's Derek, and in this episode, we're going to be talking about referencing in your MBA assignments. In particular, what's the easiest way to get your referencing right every time? This video is in response to our free MBA Q&A service. Now, if you don't already know, we offer a free question and answer service for anything MBA related, from admissions through to writing up your final MBA dissertation. If you have any questions, pop on over to grad.coach/QA and submit your question. We'll do our best to answer it. Right, let's get on with it. This question comes from a currently enrolled MBA student, and they write, "Dear Grad Coach, I constantly struggle getting my referencing right on a consistent basis. I've tried the reference manager in Microsoft Word, but I still have issues and ultimately end up writing them out manually, which is a mess and usually ends up incorrect. How do you recommend I handle referencing for MBA assignments?" Okay, so first things first, I see this all the time, that is students writing out their references manually. This is a downright bad idea because one, it is an absolute waste of your time doing this task manually, and two, it is so error prone, you're likely to make mistakes more often than not. And so if you take anything away from this video, let it be that you should not be writing your references out manually. I'll show you how to do it smarter, faster, and more reliably now. So what do you do if not writing out your references manually? The answer is reference management software. Now there are a few options, one of which is Microsoft Word's built-in feature. The one that I'd personally recommend is a software called Zotero. It's free, you can download it onto Mac or Windows, and you can synchronize across multiple devices, for example, your home computer and your work computer. So how does Zotero work? Well, let's have a look on the screen. So the first thing you've got to do is download the Zotero software. You can get this at zotero.org/download. I'll include the link to it below this video. When you get to this page, you'll see that there's a big link on this side, download Zotero for Windows. If you're needing to download this onto a Mac, you just scroll down to the bottom of this page and you'll find a Mac OS X version. So once it's installed, you'll have a new program that looks something like this. The only difference is that you won't have any folders yet. You can set up your folder structure however you want. You might want to, for example, set it up per module. The first thing you want to do is add the relevant literature to Zotero. Yes, you still need to add it once, but it really is a case of set it, forget it, and it's done. You never need to adjust that reference again. In another video, I'll show you how to shortcut this process somewhat and get your fields auto-populated so that you don't need to write out the entire reference yourself. Let's go through the exercise of adding a reference. The first thing you'll do is click on this little button up here, the plus button, and you'll select the type of reference or the type of academic material, research material that you want to include. They have some default items here, one being a journal article, but you can also find a few more when you select this section down here. For now, let's just choose a journal article, that's most common. So then what will happen is this area will pop up on the right and you'll be able to populate your journal article details. So I'm just going to nick a journal article from a study guide and let's choose this one over here. So what we'll include typically is the title, we'll include the authors, Chang and Dib, we'll include the journal title. Right, so once you've populated it, it looks something like this. Now, you'll notice that there's a lot of fields here, and the question is, how much do you need to populate? Well, this depends on the referencing format required by your school. At the very least, you will typically need to include the title, the author, the publication, the volume, the issue, the pages, and the date. There might be some other requirements, but it all depends on what the referencing format is, for example, Harvard or APA. A pro tip that I'd recommend is to use this extra field at the bottom to include some of your own notes about the article. So you are unlikely to remember what each article was about when you just look at the title. So it makes sense to go and write just your notes over there. In this article, so-and-so discussed this theory or this framework, etc. Right, done. So now you'll see the first reference is loaded up in your window over here. Obviously this list grows as you go along, and depending on how you set up your folders, it can go into the hundreds and thousands even. So it'll look something like this. So now that you've got your reference list sorted out, naturally you need to go over to Word where you'll be creating your assignment. You'll write your assignment as usual, and when it comes time to add in a reference, you'll go to this add-ins tab up at the top right. You'll click the very first icon, which says Zotero Insert Citation. And the first time you do this, you will be asked to select your document preferences. Now, this is where you'd select what the citation style is, for example, Harvard or APA. We'll select Harvard for this one. And then you'll get this lovely little red box. The red box is where you enter the keyword for your actual citation that you want to select. So let's just say we were searching for something related to trust, and we want to select this first article here. We select it, we press enter, and like that, it's entered into the article or into the Word document, and it's referenced 100% per the style. You'd now obviously carry on and write your entire assignment, and the last thing you'd need to do is build your formal reference list. So let's go to this reference list section, usually at the end of the document, and all you have to do is enter the title or the heading for the page, and again you'll go to add-ins and you'll go to the third icon, which says insert bibliography. You click this button and you'll see that it automatically populates it in the format that you were looking for. It's populated exactly in line with what's required. You'll notice some items are italicized. All of your journal issue and volume data is there, the pages are there, all of this is perfect. This is automatically populated as you work through your assignment, so you never need to revisit it apart from just to do a once over. Obviously, if you put rubbish into Zotero in the beginning, if you include spelling errors or something along those lines, they will be pushed out on this side. So that's how simple it is. All you need to do is download Zotero, input your references, and then drop them into your document as you require. So I hope this video has provided value to you. If you have any questions of your own, please visit us at grad.coach/QA, submit your question, and we'll do our best to give you a sound answer. If you enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also visit us on Facebook, on LinkedIn, and of course the Grad Coach blog at grad.coach/blog. I'll include all the links below this video. Lastly, if you feel like you could use a helping hand in your MBA journey, get in touch with us for one-on-one personalized MBA tutoring and mentoring. Just drop us a line at hello@grad.coach. That's hello@grad.coach. Thanks for watching and good luck.